Due to the graphic nature of this program, viewer discretion is advised. Of all the behaviors in the animal world that demonstrate thinking, most are considered positive. But as humans have shown, some of the most sophisticated thinking can result in devastating violence. This may also be the case in the wild, where chimpanzees can band together in deadly attacks on their fellow primates.
They definitely have the ability and the potential to be extremely violent and use some military tactics.
The question is, are these attacks organized and a result of animal thinking?
The decision to retreat or attack must be conscious. The fascinating question is, are individual chimpanzees aware that the other chimpanzees are making the same decision?
Anthropologist David Watts has spent the last 13 years filming and observing primates at Ngogo in the wilds of Kibale National Park, Uganda.
The community there turns out to be by far the largest that anyone has found in the wild, with now over 150 chimpanzees.
It's well known that chimpanzees have one of the highest capacities for thinking among animals. A chimpanzee brain weighs almost 15 ounces. It's about an ounce and a half more than a newborn human's. Nearly 96% of their DNA is the same as humans, although some of the biggest differences are in brain development. Their complex social alliances and strategizing show a very sophisticated level of thought. Chimpanzee communities are led by an alpha male. Males vie for dominance and form complicated, frequently changing alliances in order to move up the hierarchy.
Many, if not all of them, put a lot of effort into trying to achieve the highest status that they can.
Like many animals, chimpanzees are fiercely territorial. Males will actively conduct patrols to enforce their boundaries.
Normally, male chimpanzees are noisy. When they're patrolling, they're silent. They often go in a file, and sometimes they stop and sit silently and intently listen. And if they get any sign of other chimpanzee, they get excited, but they still don't make noise.
Chimpanzees can inflict extreme violence on a member of an outside community, but an attack on an adult member of the same community is so unheard of that anthropologists only had one on record. Which is why Watts's footage of this extraordinary assault raises so many questions. Hearing screams, Watts caught up to an attack in progress. A gang of males pummeling a fellow community member whom researchers called Grappelli. The following incident is graphic.
Several males immobilized him, and others were biting him, kicking him, hitting him.
At one point, the chimpanzees pause. And it seems they might let Grappelli go.
Another adult male was literally holding his arm and had the opportunity to let go, but instead he deliberately turned and bit Grappelli, and they resumed the attack.
The assault continues for several more minutes before Grappelli escapes into a tree. Now another male chimp known as Hare, who has only been watching, takes extraordinary action.
Hare climbed up a tree next to him, got very close, and stayed there. A couple of other males who had been involved in the attack started to climb up towards Grappelli, and Hare defended him.
Hare is not a close ally of Grappelli's, but he is a high-ranking male. Important to the chimpanzee community.
I could imagine that Hare was thinking, this should not be happening. He might even have wanted to intervene and try to stop the attack, but I think that would have been too dangerous.
More than 30 minutes pass before Grappelli finally descends. He begins limping away from the community towards isolation.
Except that Hare went with him. Again, quite remarkable. As if he was interested, he was concerned. And I think there was empathy between Hare and Grappelli.
Grappelli was mortally wounded, and 3 days later, he would be found dead. Watts isn't sure if the attack was spontaneous or chillingly calculated. But he saw one clue in the character of Grappelli.
Grappelli seemed to have the wrong combination of personality skills. That is, ambitious, a rival to some of these males, but not doing a good job of cultivating any of them as allies. I think that they might simply have gotten rid of a rival.
Perhaps another clue lies in the chronic violence of a close relative to these primates, humans.
One of the other mammals in which groups of males cooperatively engage in attacks on members of other groups is humans. And what chimpanzee males do looks rather disturbingly like that kind of behavior in our own species.
Yet the behavior of Hare suggests astonishing levels of empathy and an awareness that the community had lost its moral compass.
I think that Hare certainly was doing a lot of complex social reading of the situation. He certainly acted as if he thought that was wrong, it should not have happened at all, and I'm not going to allow it to resume. I'm not going to allow anyone to do more.
Hare shows that while chimpanzees may possess the terrible ability to coordinate group attacks, they may also have the capacity to empathize and comfort, very much like their human counterparts.